which sums up many of them very well, which is read by Imam al-Qurtushi, a great muhaddith, the teacher of Qadi Abu Bakr ibn al-Arabi, in which he said that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, it's related on Ibn Abbas, and there's another in the Senate, there's some criticisms. Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu, أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال, من أشراط الساعة أو القيامة إضاعة الصلوات. From the end of time is the loss of prayers. The loss of prayers. Now, I'll tell you something about that hadith. Imam Yusuf Nabahani in his Ida'a says, the loss of prayer does not simply mean that people stop praying. It means even those who praise prayers are unaccepted because they don't know anything about the prayer. They don't know the fara'id. They don't know how to correct their sahw if they make a mistake. They can't distinguish between sunan and fada'il. They have no knowledge of the prayer. They don't do their wudu properly. They pray in the improper time, which is one of the signs of the end of time, that people lose the understanding of how the times were determined by the prayer and pray outside of time. Sayyidina Umar in the Muwatta of Imam Malik said, إِنِّي لَأَرَى, he wrote a letter to his governors, إِنِّي لَأَرَى مِنْ أَهَمِّ أَمُورِكُمَ الصَّلَاةِ فَمَنْ حَفِظَهَا وَحَافِظَ عَلَيْهَا فَقَدْ حَفِظَ دِينَهُ. The most important of all your matters is your prayer. So don't think the prayer is insignificant. The most important of all of your matters is the prayer. The most important of all of your matters is the prayer. So whoever guards it and is vigilant about it, فَقَدْ حَفِظَ دِينَهُ, he has guarded his deen. وَمَنْ ضَيَعَهَا فَهُوَ لِمَا سِوَاهَا أَضْيَعَ. And whoever leaves the prayer or is negligent about it, he's negligent more so about everything else in his life. نَسُوا اللَّهِ فَأَنْسَاهُمْ أَنْفُسُهُمْ. They forgot Allah, and so Allah forgot them and caused them to forget their own selves. So a person who leaves the prayer has no tawfiq from Allah. A person negligent about the prayer has no tawfiq from Allah. And this is something that we've forgotten. And then he said, وَاتِّبَعَ الشَّهَوَاتِ, following the shahawat. And in a riwayah is تَخْتَلِفَ الْأَهْوَاءِ, that passions would become diversified. People would have diverse passions. And what that means is that towards the end of time, modern man in all his glory. Right? This is modern man. His passions would be diversified. This is the modern consumer. And if you look, this is actually taken out of a magazine that is not meant for the consumer to see. You're not supposed to see it. It's called Adweek. It's for people working in advertisements. They sell people. That's their commodity. They sell people. So if you look at this, country music keeps 225 of America's leading brands top of mind with consumers. This is called anchoring in their language. Today, more and more American top marketers are staying top of mind with country music. Get into the heads and hearts of your customers with country music marketing, and you'll be sold on it too. The Country Music Association makes it easy. We'll put you in touch with people and programs you need to learn more for your copy. And this is what they do. So they have Motel 6, Tom Bodine, with his country music guitar, playing well. Come on down to Motel 6. And then, there I am. I heard that maybe 10 years ago. It's anchored. And this is what they do. They anchor in your mind. So they want you to remember things. And the best way to anchor things is by associations. This is what they want. And this is what's happened to modern men. Everything's association. The scary and frightening thing to me is, I think almost everybody in this room will recognize the vast majority of those symbols. You see? People will recognize that. And this is ikhtilaf al-ahwa. In the old days, there was one type of coffee. Bun. That's what the Arabs called it. Bun. They didn't have mocha and java and koala and Hawaiian coffee and You go into America and I don't know, it's probably the same here now. I mean, the Americans want the whole world to drink coffee. That's a national drink. Right? Starbucks. They'll get it here and get people addicted, right? They measure the coffee addiction levels and they've got it to a fine science, a very fine science. Get people drinking it and so this is what they're doing.
People just follow their passion. So.
They just follow their passion. وَتَكُونُ أُمَرَاءَ خَوَنًا
The rulers would betray their ummah.
وَالْوُزَرَاء فَسَقَ
And their wazirs would be bad people.
Yes, men and whatnot.
فَقَالَ سَلْمَانُ رَضِيَ اللَّهُ عَنْهُ بِأَبِي أَنْتَ وَأُمِّي يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ إِنَّ هَذَا لَكَائِنٌ By my mother and my father. Is this really going to happen? Salman can't believe it. He's living in the heart of the prophetic phenomenon. He can't believe what he's being told. I mean, he can believe it because it's from the Prophet, but he needs to hear it again. It's like it's disbelief.
قال نعم يا سلمان عندها يكذب الصادق ويصدق الكاذب. In those days, a truthful man would be considered a liar, and a liar would be considered truthful. ويؤتمن الخائن ويخون فيها المؤتمن. And a person given a trust would be treacherous, and a person who was trustworthy would be considered treacherous.
يا سلمان عند ذلك يكون الكذب ظرفا.
And this is. In those days, lying would be like an occupation, or it could also be like a witticism. It would be funny people, comedians and liars and things like that.
Was zakat maghrama,
and zakat would be considered a fine. It would be considered something that was a fine. And I heard somebody the other day was asking me about zakat, and then when I told them what they owed, they said, "Oh my God, another bill." And I said, "No. Say astaghfir Allah." It's not another bill. Zakat purifies your wealth. It'll make the wealth pure. If you don't give out the zakat, it's the same as constipation. It's the same as constipation. Mumsik in Arabic means the one who's withholding the zakat, and it means a constipated one. Zakat is like the asaf al-man. It's like the filth of the wealth. You have to get it out in order to purify yourself from it. So it's not a mother. And then he said, صلى الله عليه وسلم إن أظل الناس يومئذ المؤمن يمشي بين ظهورهم بالمخافة The most humiliated person in those days would be the believer who would walk amongst the people out of fear. A believer will have fear.
يذوب قلبه في جوفه بما يذوب كما يذوب الملح في الماء مما يرى حوله من المنكرات أو مما يرى حوله ولا يستطيع أن يغير.
His heart will melt in his center, just like salt melts in water because of what he sees around him from all of the wrongs. And he's unable to change them. And in a riwayah, Hudhayfa radiallahu anhu said, يَأْتِي عَلَى النَّاسِ زَمَانٌ يُخَيَّرُ الْمَرْءُ بَيْنَ الْعَجْزِ وَالْفُجُورِ There's coming a time when people will be given a choice to be bad people or to be impotent, incapacitated, unable to do anything. And one of the people listening said, قَبَّحَ اللَّهُ الْعَجِزِ May Allah make عَجِز ugly. And he said, قَبَّحْتَ اللَّهُ أَنْتَ May Allah make you ugly. عَجِز is better than فُجُور. In other words, if you're giving a choice, be عَجِز and don't be فَاجِر. And then he said, يَا سَلْمَنْ عِنْدَهِ يَكُونَ الْمَطَرُ قَيْضًا In those days, rain will be burning. قَيْض means burning. Acidic rain. The rain will come down and it will burn the earth.